here's hoping this is actually working now. Testing for audio. Check, check, check. 1, 2, 1, 2. I hope this is working. Hey, there we go. I think it is. Yeah, I can hear myself. All right. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the live stream. It's finally working after I worked out some bugs. For those of you that don't know, just a quick catch up. We're playing Microsoft Flight Simulator today. And I've just plugged in a quick flight from Gold Coast up to Amberley Military Field, up near Brisbane. And today we'll be using Neofly. Neofly is this lovely little program add-on that you can download, and it creates missions for you inside of Microsoft Flight Simulator. So you can use it. I've got it as a bush mission at the moment. That's what we'll be flying today. Nice bush mission up to Gold Coast here, all the way up to Amberley Military Base here. We'll be dropping off some VIPs. On the flying tab, you can see I've got two people in their weight. I've also picked up some goods in the market, bought some computers, and we're going to sell that when we get to the base. Alright, so without further ado, let's get into the sim. Got our information here, let's click fly. So what we can do, normally in the game I like to activate Neofly now.
Tower Dayer Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie at runway 32 ready for departure IFR to Amberley.
Dayer Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie altimeter 30.13 wind 347 at 30. Cleared for takeoff runway 32. Cleared for takeoff runway 32, Dayer Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie.
Transporter from dispatch. Some VIP going to an important meeting this time. Waiting you at the boarding parking.
Oral warning, okay.
Transporter form dispatch. Boarding passenger, please stand by. Transporter from dispatch. All passengers on board. You can ask for the clearance to take off.
Right.
Brisbane Center Dayer Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie is at 1,000 feet, climbing 5,000 feet.
Delta Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie Brisbane Center Altimeter 30.12, continue as planned. Delta Alpha November Charlie, you are 53 miles southeast. Maintain present heading and altitude, expect vectors visual runway 15 approach.
Maintain present heading and altitude, expect vectors visual runway 15 approach, Dayer Alpha November Charlie.
Double checking audio for myself in the background here. I've had a lot of issues recently with the microphone not working after I've done these live streams. Rather me just realizing after the live stream. Oh no, we're to the left. I want to disengage this autopilot for a moment. Skyscrapers, the surface paradise, and to the south. We've flown over at Jupiter's Casino in the back there near Floor Beach. We're at the Star Casino now. All the way up to Main Beach, the Spit, just here coming up our nose. Lovely natural walk. This whole area is like a forest reserve. MSFS, I was back on the GPS course. I really think it's not that far of a flight, to be honest. My tail's starting to shift out. Straighten that up. Oh yeah, just on the map I can see Southport Airfield, that YSPT there on the right side. I think that's it right there. Just down the left, coming out the window.
Descend and maintain 5,000 feet day or Alpha November Charlie.
I was way off course. This may look somewhat interesting in the Neofly app. Let's open that up. It'll show us the course we've taken to get to. I need to intercept this GPS route so I can get back onto autopilot. Oh wow, the course is way out here. Distracted showing you the Gold Coast. Let's do that in a separate video. Well, I'm also using this new Thrustmaster T-Flight HOTAS. That's new for me. And I'm really just figuring it out as we go. I've got the camera controls on the little hat on top of the stick, so that's why it's a bit jittery. It's not as smooth as it could be. Well, yeah, that's because I'm still figuring that out. go, it's taking over. And that should take us through to Amberley. And so now we can take this time to come and check out. Take time to come check out Neofly. We can see down here it's been tracking us. Oh goodness. So it decided.
Alpha November Charlie, contact Brisbane Center on 121.2. Good day.
121.2 day or Alpha November Charlie. Brisbane Center, day or Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie, 5,000 feet.
Okay, it's just the first.
Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie, Brisbane Center, altimeter 30.11, continue as planned.
Brisbane Center, velocity 13906 is at 17,900 feet, descending 10,000 feet.
Velocity
1396
Brisbane Center, continue as planned.
Now I may be wrong, I have got live traffic turned on, but I think Velocity is codenamed for the Virgin Airlines. So Brisbane Velocity, I think that's a Virgin flight coming into Brisbane.
Over Alpha November Charlie, contact Amberley Approach on 126.2. Good day.
All right then, co-pilot.
Going to 126.2 day or Alpha November Charlie. Amberley Approach day or Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie, 5,000 feet.
Over Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie, Amberley Approach altimeter 30.11.
Hey, there's someone directly above me. They've just flown over. Velocity 1396, yeah. That's the one that called in earlier with 17,000 coming down to 10,000. That's them. And you can see them just down there on this little radar. As he's catching up, he's flying along. Alright, I think we've got a bit of silence. Ooh, Archerfield. Okay, we shouldn't be too far from our destination, actually. Can we see nautical miles? No. 17.7. Okay, we're almost there. So we're a bit out, actually. If we check Neofly just quickly, this is on the left here, this is all information from this mission actually. Starting off, this was it, and a request, bank pitch plane less than 45. Because I'm taking VIPs, the idea is it needs to be a comfortable ride. You can't be jerking the plane all over left and right, otherwise you fail. So it's track that I've taken off, wait for takeoff, airborne, speed 93. That'll change when we come back to it later, once the mission's finished. But yeah, it's a lovely little program that you can use to sort of generate missions, even create like a career mode for yourself. You make your own pilot. You start off with just propeller planes. You've actually got to do the training and pass a test in order to be qualified to fly. I think a single prop, then dual prop, multi-engine piston, yeah, then turboprops, single, and then multi-turboprop, and then you get to your jets, and then your airlines, heavy jets, that's the big boys there, and then you can even hire crew to fly your planes when you're not flying them. You can buy a bunch of different planes, and you gotta look after them, gotta fuel them, gotta repair them. You can see here one of them is damaged, I need to repair that. There are even markets, so in this instance I'm taking 2. Taking 2 passengers, and that's their weight there. With flying the TBM930, I'm not taking full fuel, so I've got plenty of weight on board left over. So to sort, I'll buy a few laptops from the Gold Coast, and then I'm going to sell the laptops at the military base and make a nice bit of money there. Alright, I think we're starting to turn, were we? In the flight sim, let's go back and just double check that. Nope. However, we shouldn't be too far. We should not be too far away. So yeah, if you're interested in something like Neofly, if you want to see more, just let me know in the comments down below. I can do some videos about Neofly specifically. I could tell you how to set it up, how to get it running. Hell, we could even make a little community series where you guys decide where I fly missions to and from. I've got this plane in Australia. The last couple of days I was trying missions in Italy, but I had audio problems, so it's a bit embarrassing. And I've sent an AI all the way out in China, apparently. No, he's in Kazakhstan. I guess his last destination was Kazakhstan, so you can really fly around the whole world if you really wanted to. Right, I think that's all we can check in Neofly for now anyways. At least until we've finished the mission. I normally just like to zoom back in, so I have an idea of where I am in relation to where I'm going, and I wonder where the... Oh no, I put the wrong information in. I've just realised I'm flying to Archerfield, not Amberley. I've put in the wrong airport, so we're going to have to change this to heading mode and change our heading. Let's fly heading 320. Goodness, that's embarrassing. Very first live stream that's working, and I'm on the wrong airport. Okay, I'm glad I picked that one up. So the mistake I made is that I was flying to Amberley Military Base here, YAMB. I need to go to Archerfield Airstrip here, YBAF. Goodness, it's the heading relative almost 90. As I'm flying up, we'll probably pitch in and probably line up to a runway. Now, I probably overshot it. But let's give it a go. Heading here, so I've, for those that didn't see, so let me just dial this in, 04, let's try that. No, we won't be closer to 90, let's try 07. You know what, 09, let's do it. It's probably flown a bit further north by now. I didn't turn that off, I need it back on now. Close enough to get us where we need to go. Yeah, so for those that didn't see, I still got the autopilot on, but I switched from the nav mode, which is this, which will make you follow the purple line, and I swapped to heading mode, which means the plane will fly wherever this little blue indicator is. So if I rotate that a bit, go 6.
5.
I think I see the airport just there. So I'm hoping that's it. Are we flying into the wind? No, we're not. Wind's coming from the north.
Over Alpha November Charlie, you are 1,300 feet below your assigned altitude. Climb and maintain 5,000 feet altimeter, 30.09er.
Climb and maintain 5,000 feet day or Alpha November Charlie. Approach day or Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie requests destination change to Archer.
Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie is cleared to Archer Airport as filed. Squawk 0634.
Day or Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie cleared to Archer Airport as filed. Squawk 0634. Heading 070 climb and maintain 10,500 feet day or Alpha November Charlie.
Over Alpha November Charlie, you are 3 miles west. Maintain present heading and altitude, expect vectors visual runway 28 right approach.
Maintain present heading and altitude, expect vectors visual runway 28 right approach day or Alpha November Charlie. Decimal 8 for Dayer Alpha November Charlie. Brisbane Center Dayer Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie is at 1,900 feet, climbing 10,500 feet.
I'm not climbing.
Dayer Foxtrot Romeo Alpha November Charlie, Brisbane Center Altimeter 30.15, continue as planned.
I'm really not gonna climb, guys. I'm putting this bad boy down. It's just crashed on me. I guess that's the end of this stream then. Well, if there's anything else you'd like to know about the HOTAS system or Neofly, just let me know in the comments and I'll get to those videos. Damn, hopefully I'll have less problems in the next live stream. See you guys next time.